right side. Harrison takes the handoff of Hinch to the second man through. That is Wayne Brown. He is up to the 40-yard line, and it will be second down. 11:30, they are 5-0, one of the few unbeaten teams in Class 5A, or in Class A, rather. Handoff is made for the first man through. That's Wayne Brown. He picks up good first down yardage. He is down to around, he's past midfield, rather. He is to the 4,500 yards. We're inside 11 minutes now. First quarter action. Harrison behind center. He hands off. This time to Michael Collins. He's up on the right side. He's to the 40, the 39, flag down. As he's down to the 36-yard line, it will be close to first down territory. This is where we'll see what the flag is for. They look to the man in the white hat, and it will be apparently against the Glen Rose Beavers as the Miners captain.
It's a face, but it's called
against the Beavers. That will be left in. Balls in the right hash mark. Joshua Harrison brings his team up behind the center. He waits to snap. He grabs it. Hands it to Wayne Brown on the left side. He picks up good yardage. He hands off to the right side. Good yardage. He is to the secondary. He is brought down out of bounds. This is a German McVay had the tackle. That is number 34. Once again, the quarterback Madison brings his team to the backfield. And there are flags in the court. The ball can even be snapped. Looks as if there was illegal motion. That'll back his team up a few yards. This is one of the class matchups in 5A South, especially the class game tonight. Quarterback Matt Henson gets nothing as he's brought down by a horde of Miners. Led up there by number 54, Brian Lindsay, as he made down 13. No, he does hand the ball off to Haynes. The first man through gets up just a couple of yards. It'll be second.
Schnabel comes off.
Two men in the wing, slots is on the backfield. That is Haynes. He gets the ball. Good yardage. Past the 45-yard line. In motion comes Chad Lanius. A couple of costly penalties, as we mentioned, against the Miners, has given Glen Rose 10 yards. And I believe another offsides call. It will be once again offsides against the Miners. Handoff inside, hit hard, is the running back. That is Haynes again. Definite hit force. So he gets up slowly, tackled. Surely Glen Rose, Arkansas. Back to pass is that same play. Pass is caught by number 25. That was Kevin Talley from Hanson. And a flag once again. Fourth penalty of the game. And it is once again offside against the Miners. Sets up the rules. Ryan Jacks, time-consuming, ground-gaining drive. Inside handoff doesn't pick up much for Haynes as it will be third down now and about five to go. Rolling set. Henson barks out the signals and awaits the snap. He looks to throw pass. He can't. Now he's going to the left side as he will be brought out of bounds by Russ Baxley.
Quarterback.
As the Henson had to keep it because he didn't have a man open past him. Looks as if it will be fourth down and handoff right side. He keeps another fish to the right side. It's an effective one, and he will be stopped after picking up the first down. He's inside the 10-yard line apparently. The pitch was made backside to him. Only two touchdowns given up this year by the Boxside defense. Pitch to Talley on the left side. To attempt the extra point. The place is down, the kick is up. the Mount Idaho. The kickoff is picked up by a number, can't hardly get his numbers in the middle, 26, that is Curtis McCool. McCool brings it straight up the middle of the field, about to the 43-yard line. Handoff made to the first man through. That is Michael Collins. He's got room to run. Past midfield, down to the 45, and it takes about five Beavers to bring him down. Coming off that pile of number 45 inside, Brown and Collins in the backfield behind Harrison. The snap, handoff to Wayne Brown, left side. Good blocking, he picks up about three. It'll be second down now and around 6 yards to go. Teams for the Miners. Handoff, or handoff to the right side. That was a handoff to Michael Collins. Flipped his infield. Harrison awaits the snap. He has it. Handoff right side. That is Michael Collins. He stopped short of the first down. Nice tackle. Joshua Schober, he could put the ball in the air last week effectively. Harrison hands off inside to Wayne Brown. He's got enough for a first down. Big offensive play there. For the Rockside Miners as they're inside. They keep the drive alive. Need to keep their hands on the football this time. Harrison behind center. The snap, hand off to Wayne Brown, left side. He struggles for a few. It'll be second down. 1:48, the first quarter run, 7-0. Down and about 7 to go. Harrison awaits the snap and hands off to Wayne Brown as he is brought down. Number 62 on the tackle, Garner Gossman once again. Picks up about 4 yards, head behind center, and Brown and Collins in the backfield. Time to Wayne Brown as he picks up good yardage, enough for a first down. Big day to the right side, two in the backfield behind Joshua Harrison. He hands off, no he doesn't. That's the smartest move as it was read nicely. Jason Allen among others on this quarter. Harrison behind center, second down and about 9. He hands the ball off to Michael. So a first quarter that shows Rockside with two turnovers to click the football deep in their own end of the field. Ball is handed off to Craig Haynes, and he picks up a ton. Haynes, the workhorse, as we mentioned, gets good yardage. He never gets to Glen Rose, and they'll stop the clock and measure. It is enough for a first down. He picks up 10 tough yards and gets the first down for the Glen Rose Beavers. The Austin Magnet 20, they've won 4 in a row. Of course, Boxside 5-0 thus far in the season. Kevin Talley once again on the carry. He was brought down, and apparently there was possibly a fumble after the play. Let's see what the officials blowing the whistle's all about. There was a flag on the play, and we'll see exactly what that was as they talk it over once again with the Boxside captains. We'll share it with the Glen Rose coaching staff and likewise with Boxside, and they'll share it with us. Holding against the Glen Rose Beavers, that'll back them up a few, and it'll be once again first down. 11 Hanson behind center. Chad Lonnie is on the receiving end of the pass once again on the outside as he is brought down. Nice tackle up there by Jeremy McDade. Also looks like number 71. Second down and 21. Defense comes up big there. Need another big play here from the here on the other side of the football. Pass outside to McCauley. He had it in his hands and dropped it. There was a flag on the play, though, thrown by the referee in the offensive backfield. Usually a sure sign of a holding call, and we'll wait and see if that is indeed the case. Jerry Bayless, captain tonight for the Miners, talks over with the referee. Clock stops at 11:19 to go in the first quarter. This time, a legal motion. Legal procedure is declined. It'll be third down and 21 now. They trail 7-0. Back to pass is Henson. He's moved plates to the right side. Throws it. It's caught by number 85. That is Jason Allen. It will be close to enough for a first down. It may indeed be enough. No, I'm sorry. It was not quite the punt. The left-footed kick does get away. It's their ball now. Brought down nicely in the backfield by Wayne Jackson, number 34. That is Greg Haynes, who got the tackle. It'll be second down and 10. yards to go. The first half clock continues going towards Tower. He gets the pitch on the left side. There's some men out there. Ryan Jackson pursuit. And see, it looks like Jeremy McDade got the tackle on the far sideline near the box side crowd. What will be third down now and a movement on that. There's a flag in the backfield, and pass will be picked off by Joshua Harrison. He's got room to run. He's past the 40, past midfield. Cuts inside to the 40, to the 35-yard line. There is a flag on the play. It very possibly could have been illegal motion in the backfield. Joshua Harrison gets the pick and brings it up to the 35-yard line, and he brings the ball down to the 35-yard line. First and 10. This time the Boxside Miners get the big break. Last year, Joshua Harrison lets up the interception. It's first and 10. Brett Watson in now at quarterback. He hands it off to Michael Collins. Another flag on the right side. What's the play? It'll be second down. 9:17 to play. We're in the first half. 7-0. Winrose has the lead. Jason Allen on the tackle for the Beavers. Flag on the play apparently was once again against Winrose. Face mask against the Beavers. First down and 10 as the Boxside Miners will have the ball inside the 20-yard line. A 15-yard penalty there. They lost it on a punt.
Hold on, Beavers!
Two in the backfield. Brent Watson hands off left side to Wayne Brown. He picks up good yardage on the left side. It'll be second down. Joshua Harrison took a couple of snaps off there. Sophomore Brent Watson moved the tag line. Harrison surveys the defense, awaits the snap. Handoff inside the Collins. Look at the Lisbon, possibly some movement in the backfield of the Miners. Not called. Close to a first down, will be third and short yardage right on the ground here tonight. A couple of teams not quite as tough. They've got a tough one tonight in the Beavers. Inside handoff, once again made. It'll be close to first down territory. It will be first and goal now for the Miners. On the far side of the football field, Joshua Harrison. Handoff inside. Brought down quickly. Nice tackle offensively, defensively there by Seven. One on the right side, two in the backfield. Handoff to Wayne Brown. He'll be close to the end zone. It'll be third and goal.
No game. Correction.
Third down and away Harrison's handoff. This time Harrison keeps it. He will be in for the touchdown. Joshua Harrison with the 3-yard keeper. And 7-6. Boxside trails with the extra point in Bendy. And that's 7. The snap and the place is down. The kick is up. It's good. We're tied at 7. We've got a great one. It's 7-7 now. Boxsiding Winrose in a heated battle. The Beavers await the kickoff now from Wayne Brown. He puts a foot into it and just bounces up the midfield to the 30-yard line. The is picked up by Heath Bell. He comes right side. He's brought down by the Miners at the 33-yard line. Jerry Bayless off the pile. Also Bubba Jeffco and number 62, William Hammonds, on the tackle. Henson. Henson awaits the snap. He hands off to the first back there. That is, once again, Greg Haynes. He picks up a couple.
Way to go, Greg!
It'll be second down at 10, second down at 8, rather. Jerry Bayless on the tackle. Lonius goes in motion. Option play. Henson keeps it himself, and he is brought down nicely on the left side. Wayne Brown with the big tackle. He had the man to pitch to, but decided to keep it himself. Read nicely defensively by Wayne Brown. It'll be third down now and about. Third down and 8, a big defensive play here for the Miners. Back to pass is Henson. He's got a man open. It is kicked off by Michael Collins. A game of turnovers as Collins picks off the pass in Winrose territory. First and 10 now for the Miners at the 44-yard line. Two in the backfield and McDade wide to the right. The snap is dropped by Harrison, but he picks the ball up and actually picks up a couple of yards. It'll be second down now at about 9. Awesome Collins and Brown in the backfield. Harrison to await the snap. Barks out the signals, pitches right side to Wayne Brown, where he's got room to run. Cuts inside to the 30, to the 25, 20, 15, 10, brought down nicely in the defensive secondary. The ball is fumbled, but it's already been called dead. Wayne Brown picks up big yardage on the right side with it first, and inside. It's like about the Harrison behind center. McDade waits on the right side, and the handoff is to Wayne Brown. He struggles forward. Picks up about two, maybe even 3 yards, with his second down and goal. Nice defensive play. Harrison gets the snap, hands off to Wayne Brown, and he is in for the touchdown. Wayne Brown, a touchdown of about a four-yard run as he struggled into the end zone through the tough Beaver defense. 13-7 now as the Miners have taken the lead. The handoff, or the snap rather, is to the left side, and there is a flag on the play. We'll wait and see what it is. Pitch out was made on the wide left side to the Collins. And we'll await the call from the official to the flag. Still awaiting that call. As Wayne Brown continues to put on the shoe. He's up now. As we await to see what exactly the call is. Still no indication. Give us a chance to tell you to cover the local high school. Bring you local high school football on AM 690 KEWI. The call now apparently against Bauxite as it backs them up. And they will attempt to back the 8-yard line where they will attempt the conventional extra point count. Harrison to hold and Wayne Brown to kick. The snap is down, the kick is up. The line drive is good. 14-7. Bauxite leads now 14. Wayne Brown to put another foot into it, and he gets this one up, and a better kick than last time, down to around the 10-yard line. Where it is picked up by foot. He's got room to run on the right side. Joshua Harrison brings him down finally at about the 28-yard line. Harrison and Bubba Jeffcoat on the tackle. Seems like Bubba Jeffcoat's in on there on every special team.
Way to go, David!
Falls on the right hash mark. Open field to the left side. Handoff is made to the first man through, and it's read extremely well. By number 54, Brian Lindsay made the tackle before I was here just lately. Handoff back to Fish Schmeichel. He cuts back to the midfield. Nice running play. Past the 30-yard line. It'll be second down now and around 7 yards. Excuse me, third down and 7 yards to go. Balls in the right hash mark again. Harrison waits this, or excuse me, Henson waits the snap. He's got a man open. Throws tip. Was tipped twice and kept a stop of Glenn Rose. Handoff made. Now big handoff. There's room for the option play, but Aaron Henson decides to keep the football and he is brought down. Baxley on the tackle as well as Ryan Jack Henson behind quarter by the center. Pitches it to the left side to Harris. He's got a little room and it's closed quickly by the defense. Third down now and 12. Getting close to that minute mark here in the first quarter. Henson has the ball on the right side. Nice move as he tries to get out of bounds. He does at the 48, 49 yard line of Bauxite, where he is run out of bounds by Harrison and Baxley. It'll be fourth down now and around 4 yards to go. Kevin Talley gets a good left foot into it. Gets Harlan kicked back to the 20-yard line. A little bounce down near the end zone. And very wisely, the Miners let it bounce into the end zone. Don't rest giving it up again. And it'll be the center brings him up to the line of scrimmage. Harrison behind center. He'll run straight ahead. He's got room to run, actually. 30-yard line, a pickup of just about 10. The clock continues to run with 24 seconds to go in the first half. And it looks as if Coach Watson will be very content with this. David Trump honors. And he'll get a foot into it. He goes down where it bounces once, straight in the air. Picked up by Glenn Williams. It looks as if he's down to around the 28, maybe 29-yard line, where he is brought down by Jerry Bayless, also coming up off the pile, Michael Bokey. First and 10 now for me, defensively anyway. They did look good the past couple of series. That time a handoff to Greg Haynes, and he gets a couple. It'll be second down behind quarterback. He pitches it back to Haynes on the left side. Cuts quickly inside. He darts forward for about 3 yards. It'll be third down and 5. Quarter. See if Henson goes to the air. He does go to the right side. He's got room to run. He cuts inside and up for a first down and good yardage. Up to about the 26-yard line as sophomore quarterback Matt Henson rolled to his right looking to pass, decided to keep it instead. Gets the mark. Open field to the left. Flag on the play. Pruitt has the ball. He moves back inside. He can. Another flag down. see what the two flags are for individually. Tackle right in the middle of the football field by a bunch of miners. Trying to get some of the numbers for you. Looks like Collins, also 82, Shane Oliver. I'm going to be able to call Shane's number tonight. He was in on the tackle. Also, Captain Jerry Bayless. Got a couple of hands on it. As we mentioned, there were two flags on the play. We'll wait to see what they are for. They're talking to Jerry Bayless, captain for the Miners, so apparently one, if not both, are on the Beavers. 10:35 to go in the third quarter. As we wait for the call, apparently they are going to push them back a few yards. The Beavers, that is. Holding against Glen Rose. That is the call, and it'll be now first down in a bunch. To Pruitt. He is brought down nicely by Shane. Michael Boke comes in and gets a hand on him, and also coming off that pile is another miner, looks to be Donovan Tyree. Turns his number towards us to make it official. Let's see if Henson goes to the air. He does in the form of a pitch. Lonius will look to pass. He's got no room to go. Now he gets rid of the football. A short pass. He had a man open who could have run for a long time, at least for first down yardage, if not all the way. Chad Lonius took the pick. Henson is back to pass. Quick pass over the middle to Allen. He had the ball in his hands, couldn't grab on to it. Joshua Harrison was right there to put a helmet into his side. He wasn't able to get toe and the left footed DeLoe. And the catch almost blocked. And there would be a running away for penalty. As there were three miners in the backfield, and at least one of them got a hold of it and knocked it down. So once again, a fourth down play where the miners are sure to be the football back in a penalty or a turnover, as the case was earlier, is going to give the Baltimore to give all these opportunities to. The Beavers are very tough football team, and they can't put points on the board. As they showed in the first half, hand off to David Pruitt. He picks up good yardage down to the 45-yard line, tough yardage. It'll be second down. Henson rolls right, there are flags on the play, and it'll be a dead ball. We'll have to see what the call is. To play. Illegal motion against the Beavers. That'll back them up. Anyway, second down. Illegal procedure, second down. Henson awaits the snap. And his man on the right side of the ball moves. Ball doesn't seem to be dead. And now, finally, the whistle is blown. Tackles on the play. Really a broken play from the officials and both offensive and defensive standpoints. It's obvious that the man on the right side moved. No flag was. Flag was thrown, but no whistle was blown, so the plays continued as half of each team continued on with the play. It will be third down now.
Legal procedure
is called against the Beavers. It's declined, and the play is stand. It will be third down now, and 15 to go. Henson does go to the left side on the option. He keeps the ball, and he will be brought down by the box side Miners after picking up just a couple of yards. And it will be fourth down.
Got a block by your runner.
Kevichley in the backfield. Light pressure. Baxley makes the catch, and he fakes the handoff right side. He moves nowhere. Nice defensive play by the special teams and Glen Rose. It'll be first and 10 box out at the 10-yard line, at the 20-yard line in the backfield behind Joshua Harrison. He keeps the ball, moves straight forward, picks up a couple, possibly 3 yards. It'll be second down. He's tackled there by just Andy Crowd here today. Well, this is a 5A South battle between Glen Rose and Boxside. The undefeated Miners getting this statewide. Handoff made to the left side. That is to Brown. I believe Joshua goes to the air here. He does it. Right side. He's got the ball, and it is handed off to the second man through. I believe that was Wayne Brown. He'll be close to a first down. He is up enough for a first down. First and 10 now. Officially from the Glen Rose Beaver faithful right here in front of us. And off man in red, beautifully by the defense of Glen Rose. Handoff was made to Michael Collins, and he had no room there. In fact, probably lost a couple of them. Harrison fumbles the snap, but that is Michael Collins. He is blocked out by David Pruitt. He He looks over the middle, fakes runs, and he will be sacked. David Pruitt and also Jason Allen on the sack. And run away by Shane Oliver, bounces at the 45-yard line, gets a pretty decent bounce for Boxside inside. Henson's back to pass. He's got a scramble to the left side. Throws the football. Picked off by Michael Collins. His second pick of the night. First and 10 now for Boxside. The third interception. Three turnovers for each squad now. Three fumbles for the Boxside Miners. And Mack Henson has been the victim of three interceptions to the right side. Harrison pitches to the right side. That is to Wayne Brown. Goes out to the side right now. Boxside side of the football field. Off to Michael Collins, and he is past the 45, close to the first down marker.
It'll
be close once again to a first down. It'll be third down or first down. We'll have to call it now for the Miners. They're at the 40, takes the long to Boxside. Harrison takes the snap and hands off to Michael Collins, read beautifully by the Glenrose defense. Center. They're set. He's back to pass. He has nowhere to go, and he will lose the football. The ball is going to be recovered by Glenn Rhodes. A fourth fumble in the
encounter.
Hand off to his first man. No, he keeps the football in the option. Nice play. Henson's got room to run. He's to the 30. Single point to the Boxside Miners, 14-13. Second down and 8. Harrison keeps the ball and gets practically nothing. It'll be third down and about those 78 yards to go. McDade comes wide to the right side. They're two behind Joshua Harrison. Third and 8, huge play. Handoff is made. And kept by Mack Henson, read nicely by, it looks like it was Michael Collins, the secondary who picked up the play. Hitting Glenn Rose. It's going to have to be everything is advertised. Henson goes to backfield. He is tackled. The sack made by Michael Boeke. Michael Boeke tackles him back near midfield. What will be third down and a bunch for the Glenn Rose Beavers. Henson, usually this really steady passer, had a chance to pass before. No amount of yards just got. He awaits the snap. He hands off. He loses the ball and he is picks up a few yards as they had a miscommunication on the handoff there. Shane Oliver and Donovan Tyree do make the tackle. It will be a defensive play by Michael Boeke. Save this defensive series. There was once again a penalty on the play as we'll wait to see what that was called. 9:15 to go with the clock stopping with that penalty. Offsides, an encroachment rather against Glenn Rose. That'll back him up 5 yards. Really not that bad of a penalty in the whole story. That snap. High snap, and he loses the football. He comes up with the map. the right side, tries to run away, and he's got room to run, actually. Pass midfield, down to the 45, back to the original line of scrimmage. At the 42-yard line, the ball will go over to the box side. But Kevin Talhout, the series line, double gains on the short side of the field. There's two in the back. Harrison, the snap, the handoff, and the fake. Up into it is Michael Collins, a pickup of a couple. After hitting the ground, Collins loses the foot. Harrison behind center and awaits. Number 85, Jason Allen tries to guess what the play is going to be and guess the snap down the blitz. And he wasn't able to and jumped off sides. Give the Miners 5 yards. It'll be 4 yards on the second down now and about three. Begins to set the next play. Harrison with the snap and the handoff. Right side to Michael Collins. He's got no room to run. The red clap Beavers bring him down after a gain of just a couple. It'll be third down and again three football game. Harrison takes the ball on the left side. He's got room to run and up for a first down. Down to the 45, 40, 35, 30, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, gone. Touchdown Joshua Harrison. He goes the 50 yards to scamper to the 20-13 lead. As the quarterback for the Boxside Miners, Joshua Harrison, counters the big brown to put a 3-2 in. He goes blocked. To score within seven, where the Beavers can still tie. Kickoff down the field to Glenn Rhodes. It looks like Matt Vincent with it. And he gets pretty decent yardage. It'll be first down and 10 for Glenn Rhodes. I'd like to remind you that coverage of local high school football is brought to you in part by Shelter Insurance. Shelter Insurance will always be there for you. See Shelter handoff made right side to Haynes, and he puts up. Yeah, they threw it rather with the ball. It was great. Henson fakes the handoff, now keeps it himself, and stumbles forward for about 3 or 4 yards. So it'll be third down now and about four. Henson behind center. Tally in motion. The pitch is to Tally, who loses the football but comes up with it. And he fights his way forward close to a first down. It'll be fourth and short, if anything. And you will assume that Glenn Rose will go for it if they did. Good scampers up. Henson awaits the snap. Now pitches backside to Kevin Talley. He's got room. Gives him a couple of yards. He had one blocker, but he has closed it quickly. Ryan Jackson there. Wayne Brown also.
Drop on your runner.
5:23 to play. Once again, the clock moves. Two, the clock runs. Henson fakes the handoff, and he stumbles forward. Outstanding athlete is this Henson. As even with a broken play, he picks up 4 yards on the play. It'll be third down now, and about five. Big play here. Fumble on the play, and with the recovery of the fumble, it's going to be close to a first down. The ball is fumbled forward about 3 yards. This is a huge measure. You'll assume that Glenn Rose will go for it anyway, but they don't pick it up. It doesn't look as if they will. It will be short. Short by about a half a yard, and it will be fourth and short. No indication of yet what the whistle is for. Now there's a flag on the play, possibly a personal foul call. And as expected, the Glen Rose coaching staff, as most everyone else, are wondering what that was for. The Boxside players seem favorable towards the call, whatever that is. We'll wait to see officially what it is. 4:08 to still go here. It will be side Miners. Henson has played a great game, incredible game all night long. Pass comes up just a little bit short there to McCauley. Harrison awaits the snap. He moves it straight forward. He gets pretty good yardage. Pick up about 7 or 8 yards. Lots of good blocking, but the most important thing is the clock continues to run. That's the biggest enemy now of the good Rose Bowl.
Get made, neighbor!
Three turnovers have been also assessed to the Glen Rose team. Those are the three interceptions.
Pass called in
for a box side from Coach Watson on the sideline. Harrison once again just bowls his way forward. And he is brought down forcefully by a couple of Beavers. 3 minutes and 22 seconds to play. First down and 10 now at the 29. Curtis now is they just want to get the ball out of the hands of Glen Rose. They lead by 7. They get the signal to go ahead with the play. Harrison once again just bowls his way forward. Picks up pretty good yardage. Jackson's going to be close to another first down. Down to around the 20-yard line. Clock's going to stop as it looks like it is enough for a first down. First and 2. Played brilliant at times. Harrison once again awaits the snap, and so he will go forward once. This time he does hand it off, and the ball is dropped and picked up by Glen Rose. It looks as if he's going to go all the way. That's number 12, Brian Spence. He'll do it. He picks up the 6th of the ball. Go for 2. Hits him behind center. Tally goes in motion. Hits it back to pass over the middle. It's caught. And 14 seconds to go. The kickoff is made, and it's down to Michael Collins, who brings the ball up left side. He's got room to run to about the 35-yard line. 2 minutes and 9 seconds for Joshua Harrison to see if he can put at least to the Glen Rose Beavers. They have come back. Harrison behind center. Handoff left side. That's to Michael Collins. Another fumble on the play. Amazing comeback for the Beavers. Henson goes right side, and he's brought down once again. Coach Watson wants another timeout. We'll see if it is. Henson kept the ball right side to make off following the kickoff from the part of the touchdown. Now Glen Rose back on the football field, and Mack Henson tries to do something with it and cannot. He is brought down in the backfield. It'll be 4th down now and about 15 to go. And the box side Miners will call their last time. 2-1. A minute 3 to go. The Miners are out of timeouts. Kevin Talley will be the punter. It's 4th and 15. After the punt, the Miners will have just about 1 minute to try and score. The punt is blocked by the Miners. It gets down to the 46-yard line of the box side as they'll have the ball 1st and 10. And they'll have 54 yards to go to score. The Miners and Kevin Talley looks to have also been get inside the 15-yard line to get within legitimate field goal distance. That's a long ways away. Harrison back to pass. He is sacked in the backfield. Big defensive play by Scott Walsh. Great ball. He's making a huge stop in the backfield. Once again, back to pass. It is Harrison. He's dropped once again. Almost a football. He'll be called down. Incomplete pass. That's a break for the Miners. As the clock stops, 19 seconds to go. Harrison behind center. Just one man on the wideout. That's Jeremy McDade. Harrison back to pass again. No room. He throws the ball deep. He's got a man open. It's intercepted. And that's going to do it. It's picked off by number 1, Chad Wadius. He